Statutory Resolution and Banking Regulation Amendment Bill 2017. Dr. Subbarami Reddy. Ah, you raised, it is there. You raised. Subbarami Reddy. Subbarami Reddy to move.
Yes, sir.
Subbarami Reddy to move.
House is approved, is approved. The Banking Regulation Amendment Ordinance 2017 promulgated by President of India on the 4th May 2017. Then, sir. I must speak.
You move. No, you can speak in there. You move right now. No need of speaking now.
Why I am objecting, I must tell at least. Why I am objecting, I must say.
I will give you opportunity in the end.
Why I am objecting, I must say.
Before putting to vote, I can give you time.
No, no.
You want to say?
Now I talk something, I can talk.
So take two, 3 minutes. Three minutes. Subbarami Reddy, take 3 minutes. Why you? You sit down. You sit down. Subbarami Reddy, 3 minutes. No, I have taken. Subbarami Reddy, 3 minutes. Banking Regulation Act. No. Nothing else. Subbarami Reddy. Nothing else will go on record.
I'm sorry, bite off.
Nothing else will go on record.
I'm sorry, bite off, bite.
Only what Subbarami Reddy says on record. I allowed him, let him.
I would like to know, Barbar government, why is going to ordinance method? Why should you give on 4th May 2017 the ordinance for the Banking Regulation Amendment Ordinance? When already July you are going to have the parliament, 2 months kya fark padta hai, I want to understand. This clarification I wanted. And also, I would like to know, government could have very well waited for the current session, they could have introduced this bill in the parliament. For dealing with essential assets, the government had lot of options, both legal and non-legislative loans recovering proceedings. They could have done loan restructuring, corporate debt restructuring, joint lenders forum, 5:25 scheme, strategic debt restructuring and sustainable structuring such assets. So I would like to know the other debt recovery tribunal DRT which is invoked for recovery of debt due to banks and financial institutions. There was the Sufficiency Act under which assets reconstruction companies could have taken over assets. The government says there is a high percentage of non-performance assets. Now there are two types. Here I would like to clarify. In NPS, there are two types of NPS. One is the people who are actually by intentionally by running away with not paying money to the banks, that becomes NPA. Secondly, due to the temporary industries like today, the textiles, cement, steel, sugar, so many industries are in very bad shape, but the temporarily, again there is a time when they can go up. So such industries, when there is stress, they are not able to pay the money to the banks, they become NPA. So therefore, now what I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Finance Minister, government should take this very important matter. NPA giving a wrong impression to the public, every bank has got 6 lakhs, 7 lakhs, NPA is not correct. You must classify between the NPAs which are done by the intentionally, mischievously some industrialists or by people who are temporarily got stuck with the stress of the industry, it is different NPA.
Okay, thank you.
1 minute.
No, no, that's okay. 3 minutes, okay.
No, no. People talk for 1 hour, I talk for 2 minutes.
There's only total 1 hour. How can I allow you 1 hour?
Bill which is under the consideration, Reserve Bank of India may issue directions to the banks to go for insolvency proceedings.
Okay.
Now you should first appoint an insolvency professional. It forms a creditors committee and then the creditors committee together takes a decision on the bank. Of course, the ultimate arbiter is the National Company Law Tribunal, I fully agree. So in the insolvency code, there is a provision to settle the matter within 180 days. So it's a time-bound resolution of the insolvency problem.
Okay.
So therefore, sir, people talk, I am a gentleman, I don't have, I am in parliament for last 21 years. I never waste time, I never disturb, and I say, Achadmika, I'm trouble kapta hai.
What can I do?
So therefore, now, why I am objecting, ordinance, if it's very important, urgently, yes, as per the constitution of India, you have got every right to have it. But at the same time, when they are going to have 2 months of the parliament session, where is the hurry to give ordinance in the month of May? My question, please clarify this.
Okay, thank you, Sri Arvind Jaitley.